With doubtnet, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question and get instant video solution. Download doubtnet app today.
Hello, here we have this question for function fx 0 to x, integration from 0 to x sin t divided by t dot dt, where x is greater than 0. At x is equals to n pi, fx attains. So for that we have to differentiate this function fx, which is integration from 0 to x sine of t divided by t dot dt. So differentiation of this, we will use Leibniz theorem. For that, first we have to put this first limit into the function. For that, we will have in left hand side differentiation of fx with respect to x is f dash x. Now in the right hand side, we have to first put this upper limit in the function, multiply differentiation of the upper limit, which is 1, minus differentiation. We have to put this sine 0 by 0, multiply by differentiation of 0, which is 0. We can see this sine 0 by 0 is tending to 1, and this multiply by 0, so it will be 0. Now we will left with f dash x, which is sine x by x. Now for that, we have to equate this f dash x is equals to 0. This implies sine of x divided by x is equals to 0. We can see here x cannot be equals to 0. This implies sine of x is equals to 0. And when will sine of x is equals to 0? When x belongs to n pi and n belongs to integers. Now for maximum and minimum value, we have to check of f double dash x. We have to differentiate this f dash x. I will write it down here. F dash x is equals to sine of x divided by x. Now we have to differentiate this for minimum and maximum values. Now differentiation of f dash x is f double dash x. Now in the right hand side, we will use quotient rule, which says we will do the differentiation of numerator, which is differentiation of sine x, which is cos x, multiply by denominator as it is, minus differentiation of denominator, which is x, and differentiation of x is 1, multiply by numerator as it is. Now in the denominator part, we will do x square. This is quotient rule says differentiation of numerator, multiply by denominator, which are these, and differentiation of denominator, which is 1, multiply by numerator as it is, and denominator square. Now if we can see here, f double dash x is equals to x cos x minus sine x divided by x. Now if we see at x is equals to n pi, f double dash x will equals to, this is square, now n pi, so it will be x is n pi, so it will be n pi multiplied by cos n pi, which is minus 1 to the power n, minus sine n pi is always 0, divided by n pi square. Now we can see the sine of f double dash x will be depending upon n. When n is even, f double dash x is greater than 0. This implies at x is equals to n pi and n is even, we will have a minimum, and at when n is odd, we will have f double dash x is less than 0. This implies that x is equals to n pi, when n is odd, we will have a maximum. Now at even we will have minimum, and then odd we will have a maximum. Now if we see from the options, which says maximum or minimum according to as n is odd and even. Yes, when n is even we will having minimum, and when n is odd we will having maximum. So option 1 is correct. Thank you.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level. Trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download Doubt and App today.